Hello everybody, so in this video we are going to discuss Article 26 that extends us freedom to manage our religious affairs. So this is second in right to religion. The first was Article 25 that we already have discussed, right? So in case if you have not watched that video, you can get to the playlist, watch that video and thereafter resume this video. Let us get into slide and let us see what Article 26 reads, right? So here it reads, freedom to manage religious affairs, right, subject to public order, morality and health. So there are three grounds on which this safeguard or the right extended under this article can be restricted, that is public order, morality and health, right? Under Article 25 there are four grounds, that others portion is missing from here, right? Thereafter, having cited grounds of restriction, it reads that every religious denomination, again you need to stop, right? It is extending right to religious denomination and not to any individual. That was the case in Article 25, and that should be your approach whenever you are reading any kind of article, that you need to wait. You need to read every word, understand the every word, and only after understanding that word you need to resume, right? So, and that's why this green strip that you can see, that it extends right to group or denomination, right? In Article 25, jo maine pending choda tha, jo waha individual right tha, and I had told ki I'll explain this in Article 26. So Article 26 is doing that, it is extending these rights to group or religious denomination, right? While Article 25, the rights extended under Article 25 was being extended at individual level, right? Every religious denomination or any section thereof shall have right. What right? So rights are mentioned here, right? So it should have right, clause 1 reads, to establish and maintain the institutions for religious and charitable purposes, right? So what other right it is extending to us? So other right that is in clause B, to manage its own affairs in matters of religion, right? Matters of religion portion I have bolded, and I'll let you know why this matter of religion, because this is the point of emphasis and we'll discuss this, right? So before proceeding to other two clauses, let us wait and let us try to clarify one confusion that I have seen among various co-aspirant, and that one confusion is between Article 26 and Article 30, right? Here you see there are two words that has been used, right? Establish and maintain institution for religious and charitable purposes. Almost same words are there in Article 30 as well, right? All minorities, whether based on religion or language, shall have right to establish and administer educational institution, right? Almost same word, right? But here rights of establishing this religious and charitable institution is being extended to almost every religious denomination, while the right under Article 30 has been extended only to religious and linguistic minorities, right? Just because the words are similar, establish and maintain, and here as well shall have right to establish and administer, right? Confusion gets created, and that's why I wanted to clarify this confusion. Article 30 only to religious and linguistic minority, and that to educational institution. Article 26, that is to every religious denomination, right? And what right? To maintain the institutions of religious and charitable purposes, right? So I hope these two clauses and the difference between Article 26 and Article 30 is clear, right? Let us move to the third clause, right? So what right Article 30, Article 25 C extends to us? So to own and acquire movable and immovable property. Okay, fine. So what is the fourth clause? Let us read it. So the fourth clause extends religious denomination right to administer such property that they have acquired under clause C, right, in accordance with the law. So again, in accordance with law means this is also a limitation. So whatever law that a state mentioned in part 3 will keep coming up, right, those law has to be followed, right? We'll discuss this in detail as well. Let us see what is the meaning of religious denomination, because this word was never clarified, or the meaning of this word was never clarified in the Constitution, and so it was for SC to have its meaning. So in Swamiyar versus State of Madras, you will see the Supreme Court came up with these three guidelines, that if any group does fulfill these three criteria, then they can be conferred religious denomination award. And those three criterias were, the first, that it should have a common faith and belief, then a distinct name and an organization. And accordingly, in SP Mittal versus Union of India, you will see that Aurobindo Society was from Chennai, right? Aurovilla town there is, right? So Aurobindo Society was denied this religious denomination status, right? However, Ramakrishna Mission and Anand Marg was announced as a religious denomination, right? So I hope you do have clarity on the meaning of religious denomination. So any group or any religion which fulfills these three criterias issued by Supreme Court, in this case, if they fulfill, right, they can be called religious denomination and they can enjoy the right extended under Article 26, right? Let us move to the next slide and let us see what are the first two clauses of Article 26. So Article 26, first two clauses we already have read, and these are simple: to establish and maintain institutions for religious and charitable purposes, right? And under this charitable purposes, one a religious denomination is allowed to open educational institutions as well. Then B reads, to manage its own affair in matters of religion. This bold line we will discuss. This is to manage its own affairs in matters of religion, right? So if there is any particular thing, right, that is particular to your religion, you can practice that, right? You have, as a religious denomination. So here you can see this picture of Tower of Silence based in Mumbai. So Parsi communities, right, they do not cremate the body, or they do not bury the body according to their religious beliefs, right? Bodies has to be thrown in this Tower of Silence, which is on a high raised platform, right? And these bodies are consumed by vultures, right? So even at the cost of environment, right, this religious protection has been extended to this religious denomination, that is Parsis, right? What are other examples that we can have? So here you have Santhara, right? So even at the cost of health, right, this practice has been challenged, constitutional validity of this practice has been challenged in Supreme Court. But Supreme Court, under this, to manage its own affairs, right, religious denomination Jainas are, right? So under this clause, this protection was extended to them, and Santhara was declared. Although High Court declared that this is illegal, but when the constitutional validity of this was challenged in by Jain community in Supreme Court held High Court's decision illegal, and Santhara practice is continuing, right? So Article 26B, you already saw ki what are the independent, or what are the safeguards that a religious denomination can enjoy, right? Two examples we already saw, right? But this right, mind you, is limited only to the matters of religion. So Article 25, if you remember, we had discussed that state does have right to intervene in secular or economic or political affairs of a religion or a religious practices, right? So as long as there, we had discussed this something called doctrine of essential religious practices. So if you don't know this, what is this doctrine, you can go back to Article 25, because wahan humne bahut length mein discuss kiya, and I don't want to spend time again here, because otherwise this video will be lengthened, and I don't want, right? So if there is anything that is not integral or intrinsic to your religion, right, state does have right to intervene into that, right? However, these two things, right, were integral and intrinsic. If you remember triple talaq, when constitutional validity of triple talaq act was challenged in the Supreme Court, right, Supreme Court upheld the validity of triple talaq, citing that triple talaq and talaq-e-biddat is not integral to practice of Islam, right? So that's the meaning of doctrine of essential religious practice. But still I'll recommend ki aap isko detail mein padhe, because mains mein aapka jo application wala part hai, right, ye aa sakta hai, right? So I hope you have clarity ki ye matters of religion why I have bolded, right? Let us move to the next slide and let us see what are the other two provisions of Article 26 C and D reads like. So 26, you will see C reads, to own and acquire movable and immovable property, and D reads, to administer such property in accordance with the law. And whenever there is a word called in accordance with the law, the article itself is extending right to the state to intervene in these two matters, means in matter of this movable and immovable property and in matters of administration. So this right is not absolute, right? That is clarified from this article itself, right? So whenever a state will come up with any law, adherents of the religious denomination needs to follow. So there have been times when the cases in these two relations has been dragged into the Supreme Court, and Supreme Court in one of the case in this movable and immovable properties section said that state does hold sovereign power to wrest religious properties of religious institution, right? And it is here that you need to connect this weak power of religious denomination or religious denominations control over their property to the Article 30, which extends minorities right to establish and administer their educational institution. And property rights under Article 30 of minority educational institution is constitutionally protected by Article 30 clause 1 sub clause A. So, their control over their property is much more larger than the control of religious denomination over their property, right? And let us see what did Supreme Court say in relation to administration. So, in administration, although constitution itself has made clarified that to administer such property accordance with the law, but again the case was dragged to the Supreme Court. In Swamiyar case in 1950, Supreme Court said that administration of property belonging to the denomination can be regulated by law, right? But administration should be left to the denomination, right? But that judgment was of 1960. Abhi conditions kafi badal gayi hai, and abhi the situation is that most of the public temples, you will see their trust and board members are being decided by the government, right? Abhi shayad Andhra Pradesh mein, right? Jagan Mohan Reddy government ne apne uncle ko shayad unhone appoint, matlab nepotism, although I should not be making political statements right here, but unhone shayad apne uncle ko Tirupati ke board pe chairman banaya hai. So it was in pursuance of this very provision, right? Let us move to the next slide and let us see the comparison between Article 25 and 26. Right. So, on two grounds it has been differentiated. Article 25 extends right to individual, while Article 26, if you will see, right, it extends right to a religious denomination or a group. Right. Then you will see ground of restriction may be difference. Article 25 can be restricted on grounds public order, morality, health and other provisions of part 3, while Article 26 can be restricted on public order, morality, health, right, POMH, right? So, that other part that is present in Article 25 that is missing, and this is a question for you, right? Lingayat wala case hai, jo ki Karnataka jab assembly hua tha, right? So, at that moment, right, ye jo Lingayat wala case tha, section of Lingayat community was demanding separate religious status, different from Hinduism, different from fold of Hinduism, and you will see often state jo hai, wo hesitate karta hai kisi bhi community ko, at max religious denomination ka right to de deta hai, but separate religious status ka jo right hai, wo matlab demand fulfill nahi ho paati. State often hesitate, that's why does state often hesitate in conferring religious minority status to any sect claiming to have separate identity and doctrinal variance from and urging to be a separate religion. So, this is the question that you need to answer, right? I am wrapping the lecture Article 26 here itself.